In this video, I'm going to show you how to make the click track play in time with you in Studio One. Hi folks, I'm Mike, and I hope you're well. So some music really does need either subtle or dramatic tempo changes in it to give it its feeling. And if you play that music against a rigid click track, which is at a constant tempo, it can really suck the life out of those songs. And you don't want to do that. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to make Studio One follow you in terms of tempo. Now, also, towards the end, as a bit of a bonus, I'll be looking at it in reverse and showing you how you can take some existing audio with some tempo changes in it and make it fit a constant click track. All of that coming up, but let's start off with the main course, which is making Studio One follow you. So here we are in Studio One, and I've recorded this acoustic guitar. You can see that at the top here, that's the big waveform in blue. Now I recorded this without listening to a click track whatsoever. It was played freeform, therefore it's got some natural tempo changes in it. Things like the chorus, which speeds up slightly, then the outro, which slows down, and right at the end of the outro, there's a really dramatic slowdown in the last bar. Now I want the click to play along with that. That's going to have the advantage that when I add virtual instruments later on, which are MIDI instruments, then they're going to stay in time, even though I'm quantizing them and I'm copying, pasting bits from one section to another. Very, very cool advantage to have, and it means the song still sounds natural. So let's have a listen. I've already added in some drums and bass here. They've been quantized to the click, so naturally they're going to go out of time. Let's have a listen from around about this section here, which is towards the end of the verse, where they're going to be in time, but as it goes into the chorus, they'll go slightly out. Let's have a listen. Still okay at the moment, right? Yep. We're going to the chorus. Still good. Oh. Oh. Somebody fire the drummer. Okay, that gets pretty awful pretty quickly, okay? So of course, those virtual instruments are just staying with a rigid click track. My guitar is moving the tempo around. So how do I get them to play together? Well, first of all, I tried to determine what the beginning tempo was. So right at the beginning of my acoustic guitar recording here, I had to listen to it, I tapped along with it, and after a little bit of trial and error, I determined that it was starting out at 84.6 beats per minute. And I logged that in at the bottom down here where you can see the tempo. Okay, so that's fine. It's starting off right. We know it's going to go out of time, but at least we're at a good beginning. Now, the other thing that you can do once you've done that is zoom in. Now, I'm going to use E on the keyboard to zoom in. And then you can just move your clip around until it roughly, the beginning of it, the first beat of your instrument, roughly matches up with a bar line there. So you can see that's roughly matching up there with a bar two. It doesn't have to be that precise, it just gets you going. Okay, now the next thing that I'm going to do is go up to here where we see this eye icon. I'll click that and that opens up this information panel. Now it's very, very important that you do this. Go to where it says tempo, and then if it's on time stretch or anything else, change it to don't follow. That's highly important that you do that. We can click on eye again to close that panel. Now the next thing I'm going to do is try to have Studio One determine where some of the beats are. Okay, so I'll just click on my clip here, and then I'll go up to the top here to this icon, which is the audio bend icon. I'll click on that and it opens up this panel, and right away I'm just going to click on the analyze button here. So I click on that. That's analyzed the clip and it's found some transients. These lines indicate where it's found transients. So transients are really kind of like peaks, if you like, in the audio, and they often occur where there is a beat. So they're quite useful to us. But at the moment, we've got too many of them because I'm only really interested in the transients which happen at the beginning of each bar. So I'm just going to adjust this threshold control here, like so. I'll drag that down. Now, you don't have to be too precise, but I kind of want to make sure that I've got a line at least on each bar. So you can see here, bar 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, there. Now, you can add others in later. You can remove some. Doesn't really matter. Just be rough with this at the moment. It's fine. Now, I'm going to go to the beginning of the song, bar 2. Just click there, and I'm going to zoom in a little bit here, or quite a lot. So I get a clearer view of what's going on. Now I'm going to open up my tempo panel. So I'll go up to this icon here, the little clock icon, click on that, and that opens up the tempo track. And I'm just going to drag the bottom part of that down to make it nice and big so we can see what's going on. So what I'm going to do is try and make these bars in the music or with the click track match up with some of these transients, particularly ones at the beginning of each bar. So I'm going to hover over, while I'm in the tempo view here, I'm just going to hover over that bar line and I'm going to press Control on the keyboard. I think this will be Command if you're using a Mac, but on Windows it's Control. And I'm just going to wiggle that a little bit by dragging that around. It's snapping to that transient there. Now that's because I have snap switched on. So do make sure you've got snap switched on. That's right at the top here when you do this. So that bar line is now snapping to that transient. I'm going to go along to the beginning of bar three here. And I'm going to do the same again. Now I'm giving you a little wiggle there. You didn't see much movement. And that's because really that transient is almost already on that bar line. I'll keep moving through. Here's bar four. Okay. Again, I'll just do a little wiggle. And again, bar five, little wiggle. No changes there. At the moment, I was playing pretty much in time. I'm just quickly going through them there. So we'll move on. I think we're getting towards that chorus now. So bar nine, a little wiggle, it's okay. Bar 10, you can see a bit more of a gap. Okay. Then bar 11. Okay. Just a little wiggle, not much change there. Bar 12. Okay. We can see a bigger change there. Then bar 13, you start to see a bigger difference here. I'll just snap that to that transient. So I'm moving through beginning of bar 14 here. There's a much bigger difference. Now you can start to see as I go through here, there's a slight increase in the tempo here. That's where the chorus was happening and there was definitely a tempo change there. I'll keep going through. I'm just snapping them like so. Now I've come to one here at bar 17 and you'll see there isn't a transient there. That's okay. You don't have to have the transient and snap to it. You can just drag it around free form. I can see where the transient would be. Okay, I'll just move it out of the way. Here is where the transient would be, the peak of that waveform. So I'm just going to drag that bar until it's just on the peak of that waveform. Now I can add a transient in if I wish. I'll tell you how to do that later. It's going to become a little bit more important later. But I'll continue as I was. So I'm just going to grab the beginning of those. Once in a while you get two transients very close together like that. It probably won't matter to you, but you can snap to one or the other. Now that brings me to a point. When I'm doing this often, just to make sure I'll sort of play from a certain point and make sure it's all going okay. Now I think it's going fine, so I don't need to check it at the moment. Now I'm just going to continue. I'm going to skip one here. I could adjust it if I want, but it looks as though it's sort of in line, so I'll just skip that one. Then I'm going to adjust this one. This is where we're getting towards the end of the song, okay? We're going to start to see some slowdowns. Very quick process, as you can see. If I wasn't talking, I'd probably be doing it quicker. Now, what we see here is this end part. So I'm just going to play from back here a little bit. And then this end part is the very end of the outro. Let's have a listen. Okay, so it starts to go a long way out there because we've got some dramatic changes. I'll just fix this one here first. This is bar 25. I'm just going to manually line that up because I can see where the peak of that one is there. Now, towards this end, it gets a little bit tricky because there is a sort of big tempo change here. So I'm just going to mark some transients. I think they're going to be helpful. So what I'm going to do is just click on this icon at the top here. This is the bend tool. Just going to make sure that I do have this track selected here, which I do. And then I'm going to turn my snap off for the moment. And I'm going to go in and I'm just going to click on some of these transients. There's one there, so I'll just click on that. Okay, that's added that in. And then I'm going to click, on this one here. That's reason. Oh, maybe this one here. I think that's the fourth beat there. Okay, I think that should be enough. Now, this one, there's not an exact transient here. I'm going to guess, because this is one of those sort of slow guitar strums. So I'm just going to plop it in the middle at the moment. Okay, so I've got some added transients in there. I'm going to turn my snap back on. I'm just going to go back to my regular tool. And then again, at the top here, this time I'm going to be looking at this beat here. This is a half beat and I'm just going to snap it to that transient. And then I think this, as I say, is the fourth beat of the bar. Just going to click that there. And then we'll see what happens with this one. It may or may not work. We shall see. Let's have a listen. Okay. I'll play from back here. It's it's actually not too bad. You can fiddle around and just get them a little bit closer with those kinds of things, but that's not too bad. I'd be reasonably happy with that. So that would be my whole track done. Now I'll just zoom out and just see the whole track again. I can switch off seeing those audio bend information there. So I'll just, switch that off. Go back to here, right-click on the track, and then tick off all, bend markers there, so I don't need to see those anymore. I'll just go back to the beginning of my track, and we'll have a listen and see if it stayed in time. In fact, I won't go to the beginning. I'll go from the point we listened to earlier, bar 7. Let's have a listen. Beautifully. Working really, really well. It's staying nicely in time. We're getting this nice, gentle ending to the song with the tempo slowing down. And then finally, I could probably tidy up that ending a little. Now, don't forget, sometimes with your music, there may be some in-between beats which are really important that you need to keep them sharp on. So you don't have to do just the big beats which are on the beginning and the end of a bar. You can do some of the beats in between as well. Now, that's that task done. That's really great. That means we have free-flowing tempo in our song. What if you had that guitar part, but for some reason you decided you actually want to make sure that it fits the tempo of the song? Well, I'll be looking at a couple of examples of how to do that next. So let's start off with a quick and simple example. This is simple because this guitar, which has been recorded here, was recorded at a fixed tempo. There was no variation. It was just at a different tempo to the current project that we've got it in. So it's a little bit slower than the current tempo we've got set of 70 beats per minute. You can see that set at the bottom here. So if we play it, you'll hear that goes quite out of time with each other. Okay, so I want to put it in time, and as I say, there was no variation in tempo. It was just recorded at a fixed tempo. So what I'm going to do is open my inspector here by clicking on the eye icon, go to tempo, and then change from don't follow to time stretch. Now, sometimes that will fix the problem for you, but sometimes it doesn't. In fact, for me, often it doesn't. So it's still very easy to fix. Close the inspector here, go to the end of the clip here, and then hold Control and Alt on the keyboard if you're on PC. I think on Mac it would be Command and Option to do this, and then we can simply drag the end of our clip around and stretch the audio. Now, I know this is a loopable piece, so I know that if I go to just the end of that bar there, bar 5, and release it there, that it's roughly going to fit in with it. But I'm also looking at those transients. Can you see those peaks in the audio? You can also just make sure that they line up with specific beats. Now, once I've done that, that looks okay. I'll just give it a quick test run to see. Okay, that seems absolutely fine. Now, that was a simple example. What if you've got a guitar like we had in our first section where there's variations in the tempo, but you now want to make sure that guitar fits in with the constant click? I'm going to show you how to do that next. But before I do, I just want to ask you a question. Are you finding this video useful? If you are, could you go ahead and hit the like button for me right away? Do it right away so that you don't forget. And also, if you do like this kind of content, especially Studio One videos, then make sure you subscribe and ring the bell on YouTube so that you're notified about my other videos. Now, back to this video. So we're back to our first example where we have this guitar which had variations in tempo within the recording. But this time, rather than make the click track match the guitar, we're going to make the guitar match the click track, which is going to stay at a constant 84.6 beats per minute. So let's go ahead and do this. I'll make sure I've got that guitar track selected there. And then I'm going to go up to that audio bend tool at the top. I'll click on that. It opens up this panel. And again, I'm going to click on analyze so that it finds those transients. And again, again, I've got a little too many. That's more than I need. So I'll just reduce the threshold down so I don't have too many unnecessary ones there. I can always add some more in later, remember, if I want to. So I've got my transients detected there. I'm going to go to the beginning of the track, that second bar. Then I'm going to zoom in by pressing E on the keyboard. So I can see my transients here. And I'm going to select this tool here, which is the bend tool. So I'll just click on that, or you could click T on the keyboard to do that. And then rather than move my bar lines around, I'm going to move these transients around. So I'll just grab this transient here. I've got snap switched on, and then I'm just going to drag it so it snaps to that bar. Now I've got some in here which I don't need, so I'll just select those and I'll click delete on the keyboard. This one's fine. I want this. Now I'm just going to give it a little wiggle. We're not really changing much there, and that's snapped to that. Again, I'll get rid of some of the ones I don't want. I'll wiggle this one, and then I'll go over to this one up here and I'll move that. Now I can move along to the next few. As you can see, even though I'm doing it manually, really for most songs it's only going to take you a few minutes at most, and it's really going to make the difference. Now again, I've got a transient kind of missing here, so I'm going to turn my snap off, okay, and then I'm just going to go to where I think that transient should be. I'm just going to click there with my tool and it adds a new transient in for me. So I'll turn snap on again so that I can wiggle that around and make it snap. Again, I'll get rid of this one, and so on and so forth. Now I'm going to keep doing this for a moment, and then I'm going to speed up the video so you don't have to watch me doing it, and then you can see the end result after I've finished. Okay, so I've done everything there. Let's just zoom out again. Now we're going to go back to, if you remember earlier, bar 7. That was where things were kind of okay, and then they started to go astray. Let's have a listen and see what the result is. So remember, this guitar was originally recorded without even listening to a click track at all, and now it's playing perfectly in time with the click track. So if you've got any questions at all, or you'd like to make some suggestions about other Studio One videos, let me know in the comments down below and I'll be glad to help you out. Now you can really help me out by following the link in the description down below to my Patreon account. For as little as $1 per month, you can help me help you by making more videos like this. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I'll see you in the next video.